Horror games. One game category that I'm not so good at it. Will it be the unsettling atmosphere in the dark, puzzles to solve to get out of that place, while monsters are lurking you down as you are scared and very defensively. And when you think you are safe, jumpscare. If done well, it can give you an amazing feeling afterward, so you won't forget it for a long time. For me, I always like to watch that content with the amazing story, rather than I play them. Reason for that? I can get easily scared. So, this year I want to change that. And what's the better way to start out with one of the biggest impact in horror games in general? Resident Evil. A survival horror game that did start out in development as a remake of a Japanese exclusive game called Sweet Home, based off the exclusive movie in Japan called Sweet Home. With 7 main games on its belt and the 8th one it's coming out this year, it's time to go back to it and see where it all started. The remake that is on PC, port of the GameCube one. So sadly, no glory that is the fantastic original one on the PlayStation 1 with the fantastic graphics and voice. What's better time to play with it, since this marks also the 25th anniversary of the Resident Evil series. Zombies and Plants, this is my review of Resident Evil 1. The year is July 24, 1998, where the Stars Alpha members are looking for the Bravo team since they didn't report back from the latest mission in the Arkley Mountains north of Raccoon City. Their mission was to investigate the place since bizarre murder cases has been reported there lately. The victims there were eaten alive by humans, they say. They found Bravo's helicopter and landed near there to look where they can be. Suddenly, one of the members were attacked by wild dogs and eaten alive. As one of the members tried to shoot them off, it had little to no effect. The rest of Alpha team are running away to the helicopter for safety to get out of there, but their pilot flies off, scared for his life. With little option left, they run to the closest mansions they could find. Now with only 4 remaining Alpha members remaining inside the mansion, Chris Redfield, Jill Valentine, Barry Burden and their leader Albert Wesker. As they close the door in the front hall, they talk about what kinds of things they were as they hear a gun sound from a different room. One or two person investigates what that was as the rest stays behind in the mansion itself. Looking around where the sound was, you see it before your eyes what is happening. One of the Bravo members is eaten alive by a human looking extremely dead. Running away from that human, you find yourself all alone where everyone is gone. Your objective is to find the rest of the Stars members and get the hell out of this mansion alive. As much as a basic horror story plot this is, I find this very effective. This is the game where it all started, so we don't see anything relative to the plot. This is a standalone horror game that is very basic to everyone. You are stranded in an area that you don't know. There are some strange stuff going on to defend yourself and get out of there alive. So we all know where this is going to be the rest of its story if we know it. So long if it is executed well, I'm happy with it. This game does it well and it is a good, very basic horror story to begin with.
Resident Evil.
In this game, you are going to walk a lot. walking around to pick up the right items that are in one room so you can unlock some new doors that were closed off from you. I hope that you like it, since this game wants you to walk to place to place with some puzzles to solve so you can get a key item so that you get to new places in the dimension, depending on who you play as in the game. In this game, you can play as one of two characters, Jill Valentine, the master of unlocking, and Chris Redfield, that is a bit on the harder side of the game. Jill has 8 items to equip, while Chris can only use 6. Chris has a lighter to solve some early puzzles, as Jill has a pickpocket to unlock some doors earlier. Jill gets help from Barry, who gives her some ammo and weapons from him, as Chris gets help from Rebecca, one of the surviving members of Bravo Team, who can heal Chris up for free if you are in the right safe room. Some plots of the story can play different depending on how you play it. If you give the antidote on time to one of the Bravo members, he will help you out against a fight with a giant snake in Jill's side of the story, or he will be sacrificing himself to save Chris from a giant shark. And if you don't do it, then it's going to be a little bit harder for you. What I really like about this game here is the horror implemented in this game. You build itself up to be scared, and when you think you are safe till the next encounter, when an enemy comes up, it's your the choice what you are going to do with this enemy. You can run from it, kill it with limited ammo so it walks on the floor, or just walk just by it and conquer your fears. It's not your horror game where you need to kill everything on sight, or a jumpscare horror game of one of that. And when you think killing a zombie that is on the floor is all that you need, then you are wrong, my friend. If you didn't go aim for the head or burn it alive while it is down on the floor, it leaves you for one last surprise after a couple of time, depending on the difficulty that you are playing on, called a Crimson Head. So you need to waste more limited items on it, and you are never safe with this game. Alright, limited items, how I forget about that. Everything you pick up can only be used for a limited time, such as ammo for guns, knives, bombs to save yourself when a monster is holding you down, herbs to heal you up, with green, red to mix it up for a max heal, and blue herbs to restore yourself if you are poisoned. Use those items well in the game. If you pick up the item and you don't have any inventory slots open, then you leave it on the ground. So you even need to be very careful what you want to pick up at the right moment. We have also notes to explain what is going on in this place for helpful tips to find items or to solve a puzzle. Puzzles are never my kind of tea, so I had to use some guides for the most ridiculous puzzles that I just can't figure out. I blame that on my dyslexia. But that's for someone who can read it very well. All the notes and guides are in the game for you. The monsters that we have start out with your basic slow zombies that you can kill unless you shoot them off the head or burn them with a gas and a lighter. Zombie dogs that are faster that can kill you if you are not prepared. Giant spiders, snakes, sharks, and a misformed little girl hunting you down besides the hunters later on in the game. The controls are a bit to get used to it, since the classic way to play it is with tank controls. Press the up button to walk, while pressing the left or right to turn around slowly. Glad they did add a 180 turn into the game. One thing I'm not so big fan of it is the way you need to save the game. You can only save in a save room where a typewriter is and need to use an ink ribbon item to save it, so you have limited save options. So if you didn't save and you die by a trap or an enemy, you will lose all the progress till the last save point. I have learned that the hard way, let me tell you that.
Resident Evil.
Photorealistic backgrounds with the 3D face models based off celebrities they were used as inspiration for the characters. Had no issues with the performance in the game. I played mostly on widescreen, so every gameplay you see is from that. The only part where it goes back to the original screen size is when the cutscenes plays. Kind of has a charm to it, so no nitpicks for me on that. What I'm really amazed by it is how the loading screens work when you have to go to a new room. slowly opening the door with a black background and walking it in slowly. Can get a little bit repetitive sometimes. For me, I see it as it builds up to the horror in general. For the cameras, there are all fixed angles with a certain places in the game. I'm happy that the controls will make sure if you walk forward that the next fixed camera angle still lets you walk that way, where you want to go until you move to a different direction using the controllers. Yet, I can see the issue with the cameras sometimes. You don't see if there is a monster close to you, because he is in a different camera angle. So if you are too close to him, it is already too late sometimes.
Resident Evil.
As wonderful as I said with the graphics on this game, the music is a little bit less. Less as in, there's almost no music in this game. For a horror game, I can easily see why they want to go with it. Make it almost to non-existing, so you can get easily more scared when you hear any type kind of music in the mansion. So if you hear any type of music, that does mean that you are very safe in the safe room, or are in very big danger where you are in. For the sounds in this game, it is not as bad as the original Resident Evil 1. It makes it more funny than a horror game. Then again, this game was never supposed to be all serious about it. It was just kind of a goofy story with funny dialogue back in the day. In this one, now, in this remake one, everyone says the line in an off-tone voice and they're not all serious about it. But why that off-tone voice? Why not go all the way with the best performance that you have, or go all the way crazy like what the original did? This is just pretty decent in my book.
Resident Evil.
We have run hell and back to the mansion, the garden, and even underground into the tunnels, where we find clues there were scientists here working on an experiment that went out of control from all the notes that we did gather. Also, Bravo members did find out there was a traitor amongst the stars, and before telling it to us, he was killed off by the traitor before we had a look at it who it was. I wonder who the traitor is. Can't be Barry, since he was helping Jill for the longest time, saving her from a falling trap, killing the plant monsters with his flamethrower, even talking to himself that he promised that he did make, and pulled a gun on Jill's head for no reason. As for Wesker, he did give Chris helpful information what was going on and give him ammo for the occasion. So who can a traitor be? No time to think, since we have to deal with this little girl over here solving a puzzle and reunite with her mother that is a skull of a head. With that, we get access to the lab area where all the experiments took place. There, we find a slideshow showing off the enemies what we were fighting against here in the mansion and showing all the lovely scientists that were working on it with a nice white suit. And well, one of them is some wearing some nice dark glasses. I wonder who that can be. Well, of course it is Wesker, since who in the right mind still wears glasses in this time of the day and be so relaxed at it that every member of his team is dying. Barry had to follow his orders, so he was kind of a traitor, to make sure we didn't came out alive, since his children was held captive by the people that were working on this experiment behind this place. As he says, we were just his little piggies for the Umbrella Corps, the scientists that were behind all of it. Their goal was to make the ultimate life form with blood experiments. With all the information he needs, he wants to show it off to us all. But there's a twist. Barry is shooting Wesker in the back because Jill did convince him that Wesker was lying. Or Wesker gets killed by the ultimate life form as you play as Chris. Either way, we have to deal with this life form to ourselves. Once that is dealt with, it was their best idea to blow up this mansion up, since this is only one ultimate life form here in the science labs that they are working on it. Rebecca and Jerry set off the timer, as we, our playable character, are saving Chris or Jill from jail, and get the hell out of here, on the top floor, sending out an SOS signal, where who is going to save us? The pilot that was flying away from the start. Very helpful. Too bad, the ultimate lifeform has returned and he is attacking us, but this time it is a little bit easier since we have access to a rocket launcher and can deal the final blow. I mean the second blow. Let's not pretend this first one didn't happen. And so with that, we make it out alive with the remaining members of STAR as the mansion is blowing up behind us, leaving every there behind. Or is it? I have finally done it. I have beaten down a horror game after a long time. I have to say, for a horror game, I think this is one of the best way to introduce yourself to a horror game genre. It is not as scary as it looks, it's only overcoming your fears. And it is not like the horror games nowadays where they want to do with jump scares and scary moments just to scare you off. This game is all about the atmosphere, and that's what I really love about it. The puzzles in here can be a little bit hard, but once you get used to it and you want to replay this game, like for a second playthrough with a different character, you know what is going to be the puzzles ahead of you, with small little changes on the side. The only complaint what I have with this game is mainly about the story about the two characters. Jill gets all the focus and all the cutscenes about her character development, how she overcomes the fearness in the mansion, as Chris is just a good little soldier boy, just doing his best to get out of the mansion and be nice doing it to Rebecca Chambers. Either way, I am finally happy that I have beaten down the review, and I am very happy with the extra costumes that I did gather from Jill and Chris for a replay playthrough of the game. I'm definitely going to do that further on in my own free time. Hello, hello everyone, welcome to the end credits of my video of this review. I want to thank you all so much for coming all the way to the end and liking my content so far. If you want to see more reviews about it, just don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, and then we see each other again next time. Bye bye everyone. Bye bye.